independence, the national government made an effort to provide labor a fair deal. And as a result of the efforts of the national government, what we did was, we tried to restrict the hours of work. We introduced what is called as 48-hour week. We introduced Sunday as a holiday for labor. We also introduced minimum wages. Then the concept of minimum wages was replaced by the concept of fair wages. Scales of pay were fixed. We also tried to give leave, gratuity, provident fund, benefits to labor. An effort was made to provide housing to labor. In other words, labor began to be treated as a partner in production, and it was thought that labor should live with dignity because it is also contributing to the process of production. And without the help of labor, we cannot carry on the process of production.
The task ahead is to promote and realize fundamental principles and rights at work. It is also very important to create more opportunities for women as well as for men for the decent employment and in more income.
We treated labor as a partner in production. The whole concept was that labor cannot be treated as a commodity to be used whenever needed and to be discarded whenever not needed. Labor had a distinct place in the organization of production. Similarly, labor was to be protected against arbitrary dismissals or punishment. And so came the Industrial Disputes Act, which provided labor an opportunity to plead the case and also imposed certain restrictions on the employer to terminate labor without sufficient and good cause. So, a relationship developed in which labor was given a dignified position. That was the effort of the national leaders. Even V.V. Giri, who was the President of India, was one of the most important trade unionists of the country, who helped in the process of getting a fair deal for labor in the post-independence period. However, over the period, what we found was that certain distortions developed, and it was felt that the Industrial Disputes Act gave a kind of excessive security to labor, and in many situations it was found that laborers do not contribute to the extent to which they can to the productive process, and productivity fell. This was more obvious in the public sector, where it was laborers began to think loss is that of the government, not ours. Let us move lazily, lackadaisically, and so labor earned a bad reputation and the enterprises entered into losses. Similarly, in the private sector also, excessive security granted to labor led to resistance on the part of the employers that this legislation is acting as a hindrance to foster productivity. And so the demands came that let us try to have a less restrictive or a more flexible system of labor relations. And flexibility here meant that the employer should have reasonable right to hire and fire labor. At that time, the word that was used was they should be free to rationalize labor. So there was talk about rationalization of labor that continued.
With the present circumstances, we see that the countries are competing with each other, especially for increasing their economic development. But they are very much interested that they should have a policy of hire and fire, especially for the working class. No doubt, the efficiency and productivity should be well ensured, well maintained, and we must have the fruits of the of productivity and efficiency in the country, but not at the cost of closure, layoff of the working class, or snatching of the fundamental rights of the working class.
हाँ जी, 96 में सुप्रीम कोर्ट के ऑर्डर के तहत बिरला टेक्सटाइल मिल जो दिल्ली में थी वो बद्दी में गई. उसके तहत हमारे को जो फैसिलिटी यहाँ सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने दी थी कि जो फैसिलिटी यहाँ है वो एज पर फैसिलिटी आपको वहाँ मिलेगी. वहाँ जाने के बाद हमारे को ना हमारे को यहाँ की तनख्वाह दी गई और हमारी जो ऐसी हालत कर दी थी वहाँ कुत्ते की हालत भी बहुत सही होती है यहाँ के हिसाब से. वहाँ इतना बहुत बुरा हाल है कि आदमी आज रोजी रोटी कमाने के लिए यहाँ से जाता है, वहाँ कंपनी कहती है कि आप काम करो पैसा मिलेगा. आज हमारी डीए के मुताबिक 3-3.5-4 हज़ार रुपया तनख्वाह है. आज हमारे को 2 हज़ार रुपया दिया जा रहा है वहाँ.
नाउ आफ्टर द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ इकोनॉमिक रिफॉर्म्स इन 1991 वेयर एम्फेसिस शिफ्टेड ऑन प्राइवेटाइजेशन, मार्केटाइजेशन and liberalization of the economy, the efficiency of every enterprise began to be judged in terms of productivity and also in terms of reduction of costs, because productivity could only rise if you are able to reduce costs, and then the margin between the market price and the cost becomes larger for the industrialist. In that situation, what we found was that there came demands that the employer should have the right to hire labor, and if labor is excessive, to dispense with labor. So they talked in terms of what is now called as labor flexibility. Labor flexibility means that the employers have the right to change the component of labor. In peak season, an employer may be needing 1,000 laborers. When the peak season is over, he may be needing 800 laborers for the normal production. So he should be able to dispense with the services of 200 laborers in that situation.
In hospitals, there are security people, there are maintenance people, there are kitchen people. So in most of the hospitals, this practice is emerging that they are giving employment through contractors. But no doubt we can change the employment conditions, but we cannot change, we should not change the guarantees or protections given to the working class under different labor laws. They must continue. After all, the progress or economic growth must bring a social and decent living of the working class. After all, it is an important factor of production.
So this is a kind of a paradox in which the society is placed. If you go with the employers and go for hire and fire, you are downgrading the status of labor, you are introducing insecurity, which is not accepted by labor. But if you go with the side of labor, the employers, they are finding a situation in which they find that they will be in trouble if secure employment continues and they are not able to reduce their costs.
ऐसा ही बिरला मिल में नौकरी करते थे हम. यहाँ से मतलब शिफ्ट करके वो हिमाचल प्रदेश ले गए जी हमारे को. हम वहाँ पे गए, हमारे को वहाँ रहने की भी परेशानी है, सारी परेशानी है. फिर हमारा गुजारा नहीं है, बच्चे हमारे यहाँ रहते हैं, पढ़ते हैं यहाँ जी. वहाँ से छुट्टी लेके आते हैं, छुट्टी नहीं देते हैं जी हमें वो. यहाँ से हम लेट हो जाते हैं एक दो दिन, हमें फिर वो काम पे नहीं रखते हैं, परेशान करते हैं, रखते हैं, उसके बाद फिर निकाल देते हैं काम पे, कहते हैं हमारे पास तुम्हारे लिए काम ही नहीं है. डिपार्टमेंट हमारा दूसरा, मैं इलेक्ट्रिकल में काम करता हूँ जी, दूसरे डिपार्टमेंट का काम बताते हैं वहाँ काम करो, काम मैंने कभी किया ही नहीं, कैसे करूँगा जी उसको मैं.
इन द चेंज सिनेरियो द गवर्नमेंट हैज नाउ एक्सेप्टेड इन प्रिंसिपल लेबर फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी टू बी इंट्रोड्यूस्ड in our legislation. This is bound to raise a conflict kind of a relationship, and what we may describe as an adversary relationship. On the one side, the government thinks that we may have to amend the Industrial Disputes Act and therefore provide labor flexibility. On the other hand, labor leaders feel that it will be doing injustice to them.
आज हम मजदूर हैं। एक तरफ से कहते हैं जो भारत आजाद हुआ तो हमारा आजादी कहाँ है? जब हम इस फैक्ट्री के खून पसीना बहा के इतने फैक्ट्री को कहाँ से कहाँ पहुँचा है? लाला जी की भी हिम्मत नहीं था इस फैक्ट्री को यहाँ से वहाँ तक पहुँचा है। सिर्फ मजदूरी होता है सबसे बड़ा शक्ति। मजदूर कमा के दिया है, उस पैसे को इन्होंने जो है अपना तिजोरी में रखा है, मजदूर को एक पैसा नहीं दे रहा है। और सबसे बड़ी बात यह है जो मालिक सामने आने की हिम्मत नहीं होता है। जब मालिक के सामने हमने काम करके दिया है तो तुम हमारे सामने आने में डरते क्यों हो? हम तो कोई भूत नहीं है, कोई तुम्हारे को मरने के नहीं आ रहा है। हमारा दुख तकलीफ जब घर में जैसे पेरेंट्स होता है, माँ बाप होता है, ऐसे हमने भी आपको जो है इस फैक्ट्री के अंदर बड़े के रूप में अपना पेरेंट्स के रूप में माना है, लेकिन उसकी मूल्य आपने हम लोगों को नहीं दिया। ये आपने ये चाहते थे ये प्रदेश से आया हुआ है और किसी तरीका से ये अपना यहाँ से थैली अपना बिस्तर और अपना टीन टपरा लेके ये अपना अपना जगह चले जाएंगे।
द क्वेश्चन अराइजेस व्हाट इज द वे आउट ऑफ द सिचुएशन। वी कैन हैव एन एडवर्सरी रिलेशनशिप एंड दिस रिलेशनशिप इज क्वाइट ऑब्वियस इन द प्रेजेंट कॉन्टेक्स्ट। इन ए स्टडी ऑफ द वेस्ट बंगाल विच आई अंडरटुक we found that the employers are taking advantage of the new scenario and undergoing a large number of lockouts. After the lockout, the labor is forced to enter into contracts because the labor has a choice, either to get the lockout lifted and have a reduced workforce or to continue the lockout and the firm may lead to closure and all laborers may lose their jobs. Therefore, what happens is that the laborers agree that we may have a reduced labor force. So 30%, sometimes 25%, some in extreme cases even 50% of labor has been converted into casual labor. Now this kind of adversary relationship can subdue labor, but it cannot develop what may be described as a contented society. Conflict will continue, and in an atmosphere of conflict, we cannot have a better, more humane society.
Malik itna gaya gujra hai, jo unhone apna jo ek parivar Lala ji kehte the, jo ye hamara ek parivar hai, unki dehant hone ke baad, inhone apna parivar ko jo hai dushman ke roop se dikha hai.
The question is, the management experts believe today that if you reduce labor and raise productivity, this is the denominator concept of raising productivity or the accountant's concept of raising productivity. That is, given productivity, divide by the number of laborers. If the number of laborers is reduced, productivity rises. Now this is not a healthy way of raising productivity. This can do one time good, but ultimately a firm must grow. It must make its labor more skilled so that it can contribute to better production. Today production processes are becoming more and more complex. Technology is becoming complex, and we need a larger component of skilled labor. That is why we talk in terms of knowledge-based industries are coming up, and we want skilled labor. So it is also the duty of the employer not only to dispense labor but to improve the skills of labor so that the laborers feel that they are a part of the productive process. Unless this type of a positive approach is taken and labor is treated as a partner in production, we will not have a better and humane society developed in this country.
So the government should come forward to help the working class to ensure better protection of their rights, because in the present circumstances, especially under the privatization and globalization, there is a threat.
मेरा नाम गिरधारी सिंह है, मेरा जॉब ड्राइवर हूँ मैं यहाँ पे। मैं उस ज़माने का नौकर हूँ जब से इनके मालकों के दादा जिंदे थे सरदार मोहन सिंह। उसके बाद इन्होंने कम से कम अरबों खरबों रुपए की कोका कोला के टाइम पे कमा कमा के इन्होंने इतनी अरबों रुपए की खरबों रुपए की जायदाद बना ली। इस टाइम इन्होंने जानबूझ के कंपनी इसको बंद करी, चालू कंपनी को, अच्छी कंपनी को, चालू कंपनी को बंद करी। आज हम 700-800 वर्कर यहाँ बैठे हुए हैं, 300-400 वर्कर वहाँ कनाट प्लेस में बैठे हुए हैं। इनको जानबूझ के भूखे मार रहे हैं, भूख के मारे, प्यास के मारे यहाँ पड़े हुए हैं। सवेरे आ जाते हैं, शाम को यहाँ से चले जाते हैं।
इन द न्यू सिनेरियो वी हैव बीन ओवर बेंडिंग टू वेलकम the MNCs. These multinational corporations are coming. They are buying over the small firms. They are trying to displace lot many Indian firms and then developing a nexus between big industrialists and the MNCs. This is evident from the mergers that are taking place. They are also trying to create a scenario in which labor is being downgraded. They are not observing any laws. People working in the MNCs go right at 8 a.m. and they come right at 8 p.m. This is a common feature. And since they are giving better pay to the senior persons, they don't protest against them. But if this trend becomes common, then it is going to affect laborers all over. Moreover, this is causing what is called as labor displacement or unemployment. In our country, during the last 8 years, the rate of growth of employment, which was 2.4% in the decade of 1980 to 1990, has come down to just 1% during the decade of 1991 to 2000. This is a very damaging scenario. And unless steps are taken to absorb more labor, to generate more employment, to forestall this trend, we will not have a better society in the country.
There is no doubt that the worker is a weak community. But if it has got a bargaining power and it is united, then definitely he can organize, or they can organize themselves into a better, a strong trade union. And they should not feel alone, lonely. And there should be provisions, and there are already provisions under the law that they are protected or helped by the conciliation machinery, by the arbitration machinery and by the grievance cell. So the atmosphere that the working class is not all alone, it is an important factor of production, and they must be given a dignity of or protection under different laws.
Nokri chhin li ab gharon se bhi nikalne ki koshish kar raha hai, sarkar ke paas jao, sunai kare ne malik ke kaisa malik, hum samajh mein nahi aa rahi.
Democracy will have to be judged in terms of providing a better level of living to all population and not to a select class or an elite group. It is in this sense that the change scenario of labor will have to be modified so that the goals of development, full employment, economic democracy, social justice, they get harmonized, rather than permitting the MNCs and big industrialists to exploit labor in the way they like. This is very essential.
Hamara kitne labor mar chuka hai abhi tak ginti mein nahi hai, aise 60-65 labor jo hai mar chuka hai, aur desh mein bahar jo hai aaya hua hai wo apna gaon mein jaake kitne mare hai uski koi abhi ginti nahi hai, aur atmahatya ki इस फैक्ट्री के अंदर जो मजदूर है उसमें से 2-4 आत्महत्या भी किया है। एक आनंदी शर्मा है जो अपने शरीर में मिट्टी का तेल डाल के और मिट्टी का तेल पी के उसने साफ शब्दों में बोला जो भाई कंपनी से हमारा कोई हिसाब नहीं हुआ और जो है मैं अपना परिवार नहीं पाल सकता, इस वजह से जो है मैं अपना शरीर को जो है मैं रख रहा हूँ।
इन आवर कंट्री देर इज लॉट ऑफ टॉक अबाउट अमेंडिंग द लेबर लेजिस्लेशन टू प्रोवाइड फॉर वर्कर्स whose services will be dispensed with. The government is bringing schemes like VRS, voluntary retirement benefit. Now this implies that for every year of service, some pay will be admissible to the person who is retrenched. This is only to soften the resistance that is there towards the retrenchment and tell labor that certain people are willing to take VRS. Why do you stand in their way? But VRS is not a solution. George Stiglitz, Vice President of the World Bank, in his address to the International Industrial Relations Association, made a very telling remark, and that was, no safety net can replace full employment in a society. And it is this aspect which has to be understood. Since Stiglitz's ideas were not palatable to the World Bank, Stiglitz resigned his job in the World Bank. But he has left a very great message, and that is, the reform process will have to be reformed, because ultimate goal of the society is to create conditions of full employment, provide dignity to labor, if society wants to survive. Legislation has not been effective.
We have Industrial Disputes Act, we have Factories Act, we have Shops and Establishment Act, we have Payment of Bonus Act, we have Gratuity Act, and there are so many different acts. Equal Remuneration Act, especially giving equal remuneration to the women. But the problem is that there is a very poor enforcement in our country. And this enforcement machinery, if they are monitored in a better way, then definitely there can be better results. So there must be some machinery to monitor the enforcement of different labor laws through this enforcement agencies. And if we improve the enforcement, then definitely there can be a very revolution.
The aim of our society should be to reach the goal of full employment. This can be achieved only by creating more jobs so that labor could find avenues for absorption. And the simple idea of labor flexibility, rationalization, does not meet this end. For this purpose, we will have to enlarge opportunities so that, as Beveridge put it, there should be more jobs and let men wait to select jobs. So we have to create more jobs and ultimately reach a situation in which any laborer, if he offers himself or herself for employment in the market, is able to find a job. This is the ultimate goal, and to achieve this goal, labor, capital and the state have to work in unison. Let me sum up the whole thing. As Dr. Prahlad, Harvard economist and management consultant, put it, downsizing can only make a firm thinner and leaner. It cannot make it healthier. If you want to make a firm healthier, the firm must grow. It must enlarge opportunities for labor. This is the message given by the management expert. Therefore, the whole question is to develop a cooperation between labor and capital. And the capitalist should not feel that if there is a profit sharing by labor, then labor is cutting into his share. Rather, it is the due that should go to labor. On the other hand, labor should not feel that if the capitalist is earning a profit, it is due because he is organizing the production and he is providing capital. The state can act as a mediator. All the three, if they work in creating what may be described as a more harmonious society, then we can go with the goal of growth and social justice. And all societies, if they want to become stable, they have to develop these goals simultaneously, that is, growth and social justice. Otherwise, democracy will have no meaning for the people. And if democracy has to have any meaning, then economic democracy will have to be built in our system.